You have seen him in movies like Soul Plane, Three Strikes, and Austin Powers, The Spy Who Shagged Me. Joining me now is actor and comedian Brian Hooks, whose passion is for acting.
Yes.
And then do you do comedy on the side?
I love, and not on the side, you know, I started off in acting, uh-huh. and most of my stuff was comedic, and it was just sort of an organic evolvement into stand-up comedy, and I'm loving it.
Every movie you've been in is one of those laugh out loud, you're gasping at the shock factor. Like when you first met Mike Myers, he was in his suit.
He was in his fat suit, and so it took me a minute, and it's like, because you saw it in the movies, but to see it there in person, and he was amazing too. I've gotten to meet, you know, a lot of cool people.
Did you get to hang out with Snoop Dogg when you were on Soul Plane?
Very much so, and we're still friends, and you know, with Snoop comes the cloud. And but Snoop is a really, really cool guy, not so much like his image and persona one might think. He's just a really cool guy. He's a family man, you know what I mean? And on the weekends, he's Snoop Dogg, you know?
Most people are not like their persona.
No.
And that's the interesting thing about Hollywood.
Yeah.
Is when you meet the people, you're like, oh, wait a second.
Yeah.
They're just regular.
Yeah. And then sometimes, I know with me, a lot of my characters have been sort of over the top, crazy. So people have this idea of who I am. Mm-hmm. And they come up to me and they're like, hey. And I'm like, hey. And they're like, it's a little weird. And they think like, oh, maybe he was in a bad mood. No, I'm not on 10 all day, every day, you know?
You can't be.
No.
Where did you grow up?
Bakersfield, California, just a small little country town, like an hour and a half north of Los Angeles. And
when did you know you wanted to be an actor? And then when did you know you wanted to try stand up?
When I failed out of college. No.
That's the answer.
On my face. No. I was always like to entertain. From Bakersfield, there's only so much you can do because it's so small. But when I went to college, Cal State Northridge in Los Angeles, I was around everything, and I started taking acting classes, and then I started running out, trying to get my feet wet, and it was just sort of an organic evolvement, and I've been very lucky, very blessed, and, you know, keeping it pushing.
You took a stand-up class.
Yes.
Called The Art of Stand-Up.
Yes.
What do you think was the most valuable lesson that you learned from the specific class on how to do stand-up?
I think the thing is that there is an art to stand-up. And a lot of people, it's been a big wave of people just jumping in because they think it's, you know, it's the new little hustle for entertainment. But it's very much an art, and I learned what I was trying to do on stage. As an actor, I did work, and it was funny, and you know, and all that. But stand-up is a different animal, probably the most difficult in entertainment because it's just you. There's no take two. There's no every audience has a different personality. So you can find it's not going great in the middle of a set and you have to evolve. And with that class, I sort of was taught what to do, how to do it, what I was trying to do, opposed to just, you know, waiting for a laugh.
And how to correct course. Like
exactly.
If the ship's taking on water,
exactly.
You
yes.
know how to correct course.
Yeah, because every audience has its own personality.
That's what I'm gonna ask you. What I wanted to ask you next was you travel all around the country. Mm-hmm. Based on different cities, when you're flying into a different city, you're driving in, do you know, okay, I'm gonna adjust my jokes for this crowd because they're in the Midwest versus people who are in the Pacific Northwest or the East Coast?
You have an idea, yeah. You know, and I have some jokes that, you know, I talk about myself, I talk about real things. I was married and divorced and I include that. And I have some very strong takes on marriage and so on and so forth. And some of those jokes, like in the Bible Belt, they don't fly so well. So sometimes I won't do the joke. Sometimes I'll do half the joke, and you gauge by the laughs and how uncomfortable they may or may not be. So you got to sort of be on the fly.
And sometimes the more uncomfortable the audience, the bigger the laugh because they're so darn nervous.
Yeah.
Actor and comedian Brian Hooks at the Improv this weekend. Thank you so much for stopping by.
Thank you for having me.
Great to meet you in person. You're very careful about.